Good morning, Primary 4. I'm Ms. Angie, your math teacher. Today, we are going to explain the last lesson in Unit 1, approximation. What is the meaning of approximation? Sometimes it's necessary to know number accurately, as in the accurate measurements, in lab, in financial records. But in some other cases, we don't need to know the numbers accurately. It's sufficient to get approximated numbers. For example, if the distance between two cities is 197 kilometer, we know that the distance, its measuring unit is kilometer. Then we say it's approximately 200 kilometer. When the boy, its age is 7 years and 10 months, we can say that this boy, its age is 8 years, and this number is approximately 8 years. Not 8 exactly, but the nearest number to 7 years and 10 months is 8. Okay? So, now, from all which we said now, what is the exactly meaning of approximation? Approximation means replacing the exact number by another simpler number near to the exact number, near to it, okay? And we have the symbol of approximation, which is approximately. This sign, we read it approximately, okay? We have the rounding rhyme. We have a numbers. The number, we have a strong number and the weak number. Strong number from 5 to 9. And weak number from 0 to 4. Okay, so we have a rhyme for it. 0 to 4, slide to the floor. 5 to 9, climb to the vine. Okay, so if we have weak number, we will leave the number as it is. If we have a strong number, we increase it by 1. Again, 0 to 4, slide to the floor. 5 to 9, climb to the vine. Okay, now, let's revise on the place value. At first, when we write the decimal number, we have to parse whole number and the decimal number. And between them, we must put the point, the decimal point. Let's know what is the place value of the whole number. As we usual, the first number on the left of the point is a unit, and then tens. 100,000, 10,000, 100,000. And the numbers on the left. We start also from the right of the point. From the right of the point exactly. The first number is tens, then hundreds, then thousands. And note that if he asked me to approximate to the nearest 10,000, he can write it by English and also write the sign of approximation and then write in math, 10,000 in math, and also in 100,000, write it in English or in digits. Approximate to the nearest 1,000, the same, write it in English or in digits, and also hundreds and tens. In the unit, he can write it approximate to the nearest unit or approximate it to the nearest whole number. And whole number, it means unit. And the unit is the number which is exactly on the left of the point. Approximate to the nearest tenth, and we know that the tenth is the first number on the right of the point. He can write tenth, or one decimal place, or 0.1, or 1 over 10. All these four forms, it means approximate to the nearest tenth. Okay. Now, how to approximate any number? At first, look at the digit in the place value to be rounded to, the place which he asked about it. Okay, and then look to the right of it, and see if this number weak or strong. If it's strong, increase the number which he asked by one. If this number on the right of the digit is weak, we will leave the number as it is without any changes. And then remove everything to the right of the digits or replace them by zero. Let's see the examples. Now we have 218 and 16 hundredths. We want to approximate it to the nearest tens. Now, what is the tens? The one is the tens. Now, put backslash between 1 and 8. And then, look to the 8. To the right of the tens. To the right of the tens. Look to the digit which on the right of the tens. 8 is strong or weak? Strong. So, climb the vine. So, 8 will give 2 1, sorry, 1 2, will give 1 another 1, it will be 2. So, it will be 220. And remove the decimal part, just replace any digit in the whole part by zeros. 220. And remove all the decimal part. Okay? Now, 990,909. We want to approximate it to the nearest hundred. Where is the hundred place here? 9 here is a hundred. Put backslash between 9 and 0, the hundred and tens, and look to the tens, to the digit which on the right of the hundred. It's 0. It's weak. It's weak number. So, we just write the number as it is and replace any number on the right of the hundred by zeros. Just like that. So write it 990,900. Next example. 99,999. We want to approximate it to the nearest thousand. Now, what is the thousand? The fourth nine. The fourth nine. Just put backslash between 1,000 and 100 and look to the right of the 1,000. It's 9. It's strong. So, it will give the 9 1. Now, 9 will be 10. We'll write 10 all? No. We put 0 and carry up 1 on the next 9. It will be 10. So, the number will be 100,000. 100,000. Next example, 15,674. We want to approximate it to the nearest thousand. Now, what is the 10,000? 4 is a unit, 7 tons, 600, 5,000, 1 is a 10,000. Just put backslash between the 10,000 and the 1,000, between 1 and 5. And look to the right of the 1. 5 is a strong. It will give 1, another 1. It will be 2. And replace all the digit on the right of the 1 by zeros. So it will be 20,000. Now, the next example. 249,108. We want to approximate it to the nearest 100,000. At first, search about the 100,000. Where is the 100,000 here? It's 2. Okay, put backslash between 2 and 4 and look to the right of the 2. It's 4. 4 is weak. So, it will not do anything. Plus, so, 2, we'll write it as it is and replace all the digit on the right of the 2 by zeros. It will be 200,000. Now, 53.5. We want to approximate it to the nearest units. Where is the units? It's the first number on the left of the point. Just put backslash on the point and then look to the 5. 5 is a strong. It will give 3, 1. It will be 54. Next example, 3.92. We want to approximate it to the nearest one decimal place. What is the meaning of one decimal place? It means the first decimal on the left, on the right of the point, or the tenth. Okay, so 9 is the tenth. Just put backslash between 9 and 2. 9 is the week. It didn't do anything. It will be 3.9. It will be 3.9 because it's 2 is a weak number. Now, 449 and 3 quarters. We want to approximate this number into to the nearest 1 over 10. What is the meaning of 1 over 10? It means tenths. So, what is the tenth here? It's a mixed number. Can we approximate the mixed number? Yes, but at first, we must convert it into decimal. We must convert it into decimal. Remember, how we convert into decimal? By the levers. Do you remember the levers? 2, its lever is 5. We get 10. 4, its lever is 25. We get 100. 8, its lever is 125, we get 1,000. Here we have 4. What is the lever of 4? 25. So, we'll multiply up and down by 25. It will be a whole as it is, 449. And 3 times 25, it will be 75. 4 times 25, it will be 100. Now, we have 2 zeros in the denominator. Put 2 dashes and point. Write from the right side, from the numerator, 5, 7, and write the whole as it is. It will be 449.75. Now, what is the tenth? 7 is the tenth. Put backslash between 7 and 5, and 5 is a strong number. It will give 7, 1. So, it will be 8. So, the number approximately 449.8. The last example, 3187 centimeter. We want to convert it into nearest meter. Okay, at first we must convert centimeter into meter. Okay, to convert from centimeter to meter, from small to big, divided 100. Divide this number by 100, just write number as it is, and put the point after 2 digits. It will be 31.87 meter. Now, approximate it. If he asks to approximate any unit to the nearest meter, nearest kilometer, nearest any unit, approximate to the nearest unit, to the nearest whole number. Okay? Now, what is the unit here? The unit is 1. Look to the right of it. It will be 8. 8 is a strong. Give 1 another 1. It will be 32 meter. This is approximately of 3,187 centimeter. Approximately, it will be 32 meter. This is all about approximation. Thank you for listening to me today. I hope that you understand the lesson. See you next time. Bye.